Morry Altar is beloved as far as Channel 2's transmitter can reach, but we've discovered Flatbush, Brooklyn is the epicenter of Morry mania.
You guys know Morry Altar, right?
Who?
Who?
What's your favorite Morry Altar story?
Every other story that he was on, he was very good, very good.
Name one story he did.
This self-described Morry enthusiast is upset he'll never get the chance to walk with Morry on camera.
You're sad to see him go?
Yes, of course, yes.
Right. Young man, too.
Not really.
The year was 1973 when Morry Altar walked into this restaurant and ordered a sandwich. They decided to commemorate that moment, and they altered the name of the restaurant in his honor.
Came inside this restaurant to eat, you know, make fun of everybody.
It's hard to believe when Morry Altar started at Channel 2, this block in Brooklyn was in black and white. It was Morry who added the color.
Oh, that's good.
You like that? Is that good?
Yeah.
It's something Morry would write, don't you think?
Yeah, sort of.
Yeah, how's my hair?
It's all right.
Even after he hit the big time, Morry never forgot about Flatbush. Despite the money and the success, he still bought all of his suits right here in the neighborhood. And he spared no expense bringing his suits and shirts to Brooklyn to get them dry cleaned by the finest people. What do you think of Morry?
Oh, Mario Povich. He's done a wonderful job for the past years, and, you know, now he's retiring. He's going away now. So we're going to wish him the best and hope he, you know, take care, and God bless him, man.
Morry actually used this mic. Do you want to hold it?
Of course, I would hold it. Definitely.
You can feel the power, right?
I could feel the power shaking me right now.
Morry wasn't born in New York, but he got here as fast as he could. Now he's leaving as fast as he can. Morry, New York will be lessy without you.